So I have to admit something. In the last lecture, I lied. I'm not going to give you 5 red flags to look for. I'm actually going to give you 6. So enjoy the bonus tip. In my experience, a lot of people graze over what I consider effectively what are mines, things that are going to blow up later. And I think that there are a lot of red flags that you might skip over because you don't have a lot of experience with this. There are also a lot of things when it comes to selecting your freelancer that you might be a little waffly on because you're new to this, you're not sure how I should interpret something. Well, I'm going to interject my opinion to give you a little bit of guidance. Take it for what it's worth. The first thing I want to say is, number one, if the person that I'm talking to when I'm trying to build my shortlist says that they don't have Skype or they don't offer that, that is a red flag for me. That's just odd to me. I think it's very strange that they don't use Skype and they are contracting. That means to me that they don't have a lot of experience contracting, or they're not realistic about how much kind of connectivity this project's going to require. Typically, the best way of hashing someone out is ask for their Skype. You can talk on Skype, have a real-time conversation. Personally, I don't like to video Skype with all of my contractors. That just would get a little onerous. It would take a little bit too much time. I like to just text Skype, message chat, and having a quick conversation with them, you can get a feel for how competent you think they are, how interested they are, and the other 5 criteria that we listed in the previous lecture. No Skype, I consider that a red flag, especially if they say, no, I don't have one, or you ask for it and they don't give it to you. That's weird. You need to have real-time feedback. You're not going to run this project through messages on Elance or Odesk. The second one, and I kind of touched on this a little bit last time, misdescriptions. You know, it's nice that a lot of people will put some time into their responses and their bid, but actually read it and make sure that there's nothing in there that's completely off. I've had actually many, many instances where someone sounds like a good applicant, but then one sentence in what they responded to my thing makes no sense. I've had outsourcing a web application and the contractor kept calling it a mobile application. I don't know what that says to you, but that says to me they weren't paying attention, or maybe they're just not that good. Well, there are a lot of things that make a good developer. One of them is attention to detail. And if they didn't pick up on that, they might be overstressed. Maybe they're overworked. Regardless, it's just not something that I want in my project. Number 3, are they overly anxious to start the project? You'll notice this, especially on freelancer.com. In freelancer.com, there are too many freelancers. There are 7 million of them versus Odesk, which was 3-point-something. And what'll happen is they kind of have this problem where it feels like the squeaky wheel gets the grease. They have to shout to get noticed. So a lot of times you have people that are anxious to start the project. They're like, yes, yes, whatever you say is fantastic. Let's do this. A lot of them will be very active about getting you off of the website. And their first message, they'll say, I can do this. Contact me on Skype or something like that. I'm not saying don't engage with them, but that is a red flag for me. That is just too strange. For me, it means that they're not very mature. It means that they're trying to do a quick grab. It means that they're probably not realistic about what your project's going to take. ¶¶